Turkish television has quoted the country's foreign minister as saying that NATO will take command of the operation in Libya. This comes as coalition forces have launched airstrikes on the country for almost a week now, with explosions and gunfire shaking Tripoli and other Libyan cities. Fighting between Colonel Gaddafi's troops and the opposition's intensifying in the west of the country. RT's Paula Sleer has the latest from Tripoli.
Well, what we're noticing more and more is that the momentum for this operation in Libya remains in the balance. It's literally hanging in the balance, because on the international front, we're seeing that coalition forces are now not agreeing in terms of how to move forward. One of the towns that the coalition hit, according to them, was the town of Misrata, and they're insisting that they've managed to stem the government force advancement there. But we are hearing conflicting reports, some of those reports suggesting that for days now, the town has been unable to have access to water, fuel and electricity, that Gaddafi soldiers are literally going from house to house, that they've hit the local hospital. Here in Tripoli, in the early hours of this morning and for several hours afterwards, there were loud explosions. There was also anti-aircraft gunfire exploding in the sky. So Tripoli again coming under intensive fire overnight. Now, the coalition has insisted that the airstrikes have been successful. It says that Gaddafi's air capability has been completely wiped out. He is denying this. He says that he has air capability to continue for some time to come. The rebels themselves are now starting to find themselves in an incredibly difficult position. They are calling on the international community for some kind of preemptive strikes as they try to advance forward. The stalemate on the ground is that the rebels do not have the weaponry, they do not have the rank and command structure, and they certainly do not have the experience to take on Gaddafi's soldiers. But those soldiers in turn do not have the numbers. So you have this situation on the ground where neither group is able to actually move forward and advance. Already now, for three straight days, NATO leaders have been meeting to try and decide who can actually move forward, who can take control of this operation over Libya. And today they're set to meet for a fourth day, and there seems to be no agreement in sight. Turkey is one of those countries that is most critical. The sticking point is essentially the killing of civilians, and Turkey insisting that there can be no civilians killed in such an operation. But of course, the other European powers are saying that there needs to be, and inevitably there will be, some kind of collateral damage, that of course they try not to injure civilians, but civilians will always get caught in the crossfire. The Obama administration is being caught red-faced, because for days now we've heard the American president insist that America is handing over control of this operation to NATO countries. And he keeps saying that this is going to happen soon. But certainly in terms of the cracks we're seeing on the international front, it doesn't seem as if it's going to happen anytime soon. Here on the ground, the rebel groups themselves are divided in terms of how they want to move forward. And even now here in the capital city of Tripoli, which is traditionally the stronghold of Muammar Gaddafi, we are hearing preliminary reports of some of his former supporters starting to meet in secret. Now, from the coalition airstrikes and from the coalition community, we know that for 6 days these airstrikes have been happening. Overnight and into the early hours of this morning, we are being told that they hit military bases around the country, but a different story emerging, as it always does, from the capital city. Here we're being told that a number of civilians have been killed and injured. So we went to see for ourselves, but we couldn't prove anything because the coffins were closed, and the rumors are that these bodies are fake. Possibly they're the bodies of soldiers killed, or even bodies brought in from other cities where there's been heavy fighting on the ground. This is a mass funeral for 36 people who we're being told are civilians that were killed in coalition airstrikes. Now, the crowd, which easily reaches some 400-500 people, is incredibly angry. They fluctuate between prayers and these outbursts of anger. They call for Sarkozy to go down. They go down, down Obama. They condemn the international community for what they say are illegal actions. The family has gathered here. They will take the coffins to family plots from where they will be buried. But for now, friends, relatives, just ordinary people in the city of Tripoli have come to pay their last respects. The mood is incredibly angry. People here very, very frustrated at what they say is the killing of innocent people. Paul Sleer, RT, Tripoli.